Welcome back, or welcome for the first time, to Race 8 at Rio de Janeiro of the 2021 Asia-Pacific Super Cup, and to the worst no-win situation since the Kobayashi Maru. What do I mean by that? This is the forecast for the three race days. Heavy rain today, lighter rain for quali and the race. If this is true, we'll be needing inters for the next 2 days, and therefore we'll want to aim for a bonus on inters, and probably one dry set as well, since it may not rain for the entire race. It's dry right now, but the water on track is going to shoot skyward into the wet zone because, as predicted, it's going to dump down today. Out of that entire section, there might, maybe, possibly be 1 or 2 minutes worth of inters water on the track, so we could go out on inters, except that if you're on the wrong tyre, your active knowledge growth slows to a crawl, and for the vast majority of that time, we would be on the wrong tyres, or we can go to wets, which will probably be completely useless to us in the next 2 days, because if the forecast is right, it won't rain heavily enough for those to be of any use. I think it's best if we try to do it right, I say that in air quotes. We'll launch on ultras in case we get a dry patch in quali or a short dry stint in the race, switch to wets when the rain comes, and then, assuming that it dries out again, switch back to ultras. I'm going to do the car. Oh no, before I do that, the splash screen. The splash screen looks looking really, really good. I shall leave you to read those numbers yourself. But yeah, we're really starting to put in some effort now that we've got the new gearboxes in. And next time out at Sydney, once we've got the front wing out, that's going to be very nice indeed. I shall now do the car setup and then come back to you. Not a lot of acceleration to be done here. Top speed is critical. Let's go out there and do some top speed. Continue on and take the practice. Right, paused in. No, we haven't. We did not pause. It did not recognize the spacebar. All right, now what are we going to do here in terms of this? Daniela is going to go out on race trim, because that's going to be our secondary thing. Tyre choice will be unchanged, of course, centre out. And Leoncio is going to try and rack up some nice, juicy qualifying trim for us. Three laps. Will we even have three laps? We probably will. Okay, so let's get him out of here. Continue, send out. Now, I am going to crank them up. Well, maybe not that high. No, we can go to high engine mode, because he won't have very much time. I'm not convinced that this is going to do any particular good, because it's time on track that matters, not so much the distance that you cover, as far as I have been able to tell. So let's crank that back out, and I did do an experiment on that a couple seasons back. Alright, so active knowledge is coming up nicely for ultra soft tyres, as you would expect. How much time have we got? Not a hell of a lot. That red bar is heading towards rain very, very rapidly, and the rain is in fact already here. Let's go back to one time. How much time do we do? Do we actually get a time on that? Farrar is getting purples on sectors 1 and 2, so I don't think he's got a time yet. No, he doesn't. So there he goes. Okay, so we're going to have to bring him in now and bring her in now. Now, the advantage of that as well is that that means that the water on track, we're skipping over most of the inters period and going straight into the wet period. And then look at the back end of that. Drops like a stone. Alright, so we've got them up pretty much as high as we can get them. Let's go up to two times and get them in. Number two looks like she'll be coming in first. That's Daniela. Alright, here she comes. Seriously? Seriously? You've got to be kidding me. All right, let's try going higher on the downforce up to 15.1 because it was always found around 14.7 up to 15 previously. So let's assume that that's actually a pretty wide movement for the downforce because the downforce excellent tends to be in a pretty narrow sliver. So let's see what happens with that. In terms of the handling, good, my muscular backside. All right, so let's get that back to... Let's assume that we're going to have to go to the soft side, 75. Mainly because to the hard side would be an absolute extreme value. So the most of the green bar is back this way, I will admit that, but I have a feeling that this is probably more likely. Gear ratios, I'm just going to leave them as is because that's already shifted by about the value of a notch. Stints, we will put her out for 4 again because she's not going to be out there for that long. That is probably going to be at most about 4 to 5 minutes. So the tyre choice is going to be wets for that. We'll send her out. Get out of here, 17 seconds. A waste of time. Get out! Seriously? Seriously? Alright, I'm going to pull that back to 14.7 again because these two seem to be the values that have always yielded excellent in the past. One or the other has yielded excellent. Handling, I am going to assume that we're going to go towards the soft side simply because the game does not seem to like extremes very much. I will not say never, but it generally, as a rule of thumb, does not prefer extremes. Gear ratios, on the other hand, there's obviously a hell of a lot more green down in this direction than there is up in this direction. So if we have to move from okay through to excellent, it's almost certainly going to be towards the long side. And also, this is predominantly a top speed track with a couple of acceleration bits thrown in. Okay, so 63, okay, good, great, excellent. Right, that should be 81. 81, yes. All right, stints are going to be 3 laps in qualifying trim. Tire choice is going to be wets. Get out of here, Leoncio. 22 seconds. Go, go, go. All right, let's get up to 4 times just to get them out. They're wasting so much time. All right, so what have we got? We've got... We haven't even hit level 1 on ultra soft tyres yet. We have not hit level 1 on qualifying trim yet. We haven't hit level 1 on race trim yet. It's already down to 9 minutes 54. Alright, let's get up to 2 times. Actually, let's go to a full 12 times just to get them to the starting line. So we can see what sort of time they do. Set up level unlocked. Ah, great. Medium. Good. How wonderful. Alright, let's get it back to 2 times. Qualifying trim, finally! Qualifying trim is unlocked. We are the only ones out there on non-dry tyres. The other teams should not be getting particularly good results at the moment. Yes, they're getting more time on those tyres, but they won't be increasing their active knowledge by squat. Alright, so I'm thinking, whereabouts are they? They've just gone past, so we'll bring in at the end of this lap. Are they even going to get a level 1 on these wet tyres? Yeah, it looks like they will. Yeah, they've got a level 1 on the wet tyres, that's something. Should probably bring them up. So the wet tyres aren't doing us any good at the moment. Well, there is a combination of good news and bad news here. Alright, so the great, in terms of that, that is where we were only good. That's where we're great. Now, is it possible that I have gone through a great, past an excellent, and out the other side? It's always possible, but I don't think it's exceptionally likely. So I'm going to keep going towards the high by just a very small smidge. Just inch it out. And then maybe we'll still have time to try another setting in qualifying if that one doesn't work. Now, we've only got 6:04 left. I'll give her 8 laps because it doesn't cost us any time to put the fuel in anyway. Tire choice, 4 to 6 on those. Yeah, that'll be fine. I don't want to burn through a tire set unnecessarily, although on this occasion, no, we're going to need at least two sets for quali if it is dry tomorrow, which is not forecast to be, but it may be for one stint. What to do? I'll give her a fresh set. We've got enough. Okay, let's send her out of here. Go, go, go. Leoncio, get in here. Ah, spit upon your face, monsieur. We probably shouldn't start that again. Okay, so, this is so painful. Right, it's great there, and it's great where the current indicator is. Is it possible that the excellent sits in between? I would say yes, it is entirely possible. We're going to have to finesse this and probably actually split the rear wing, split the wing angle so that they're not exactly 10%. So let's go to 14.8. And the reason that I'm putting more downforce on the rear wing is because that's the critical part here. So if we bring that to 24.9, so that's 10.1. If we then take a look at that, so it sits roughly in the middle of those two. Now, similarly, with the handling, I got a sneaking suspicion that the excellent is somewhere in between those two. And part of the reason for that is that actually last year, the tyre camber on one of the cars, and I think it was Leoncio's, did actually have to... No, it was actually... Yeah, it was Leoncio's. Did actually have to be set to 2.0, which is the really flat camber. So I'm betting it's going to be exactly the same thing this time. So it's unusual for a handling range to be that narrow for the excellent. Generally, it's a little bit wider than that, but it's not impossible. We've seen it before. Okay, I'm going to leave the suspension stiffness and the gear ratios as they are. That's actually shifted the speed balance slightly off that, but if we need to come back to that, we know where it is. Stints, I'm going to send him out a three lap simply because it's not going to cost me anything further. I'm going to give him a fresh set of ultrasofts too. Now, 556, I don't know whether I'm going to get away with this. I want level 2 qualifying trim. We're almost there. We might as well get it. Race trim isn't even at level 1 at the moment. I do want to see if I can get that up to level 2. And the only way I'm going to do that is if I send Leoncio out for a very quick lap to try to get as much time under his belt in flying laps as possible. So I have a feeling that's where the greatest part of the value is accumulated. And then get him in and try and get him out in race trim. I don't know whether we're going to get away with it, but there's no further water on track. So, dry tires it is. Get him out of here. Alright, let's get up to 4 times. And then drop back, because I want to push him up into attack mode. Now, why am I doing that? Because if it is actually the flying laps that matter, then this lap is going to matter less than the next lap that he does. Okay, so we've got to level 1 on ultrasofts. Gee, that's nice. We might get to level 2. I might actually push Daniela up to high on her engine because she has the engine to spare. Should I actually push her tires up as well? Yeah, let's push them up. Alright, so let's get up to 2 times. Actually, let's be careful about that, because as soon as we hit level 2 qualifying trim, that's when I'm going to want to bring Leoncio in. Now, let's get back to 1 time, because Leoncio, drop back. Gear ratios feel just right. How close are you? Damn close. Can you make it? You're not going to... Yes, you have. Come on in. Qualifying trim level 2. Get in here as quickly as possible. Send out. Well, it has increased by 2% because it was 94 last time. Now, I am actually going to work on the assumption that we actually are not finding the excellent in the middle of any of those anyway. So I'm going to pull it back to 14.6. Why am I pulling it back to 14.6? First of all, Like I said, top speed is the most important thing. High speed corners are also important. Acceleration is useful, but not critical. And the other reason is that look at the way these green bars have shrunk down. That is pretty much dead in the center. Just as this one is pretty much in the center of that. That's actually pulled the speed balance off by quite a little bit. Let me just see if we can... Right, 22.2 PSI. That's put it pretty much back exactly where it was previously. And that is still going to be on the low side of anything that we've tried so far. So that's my rationale behind that. It may be right or it may be wrong. You are going to go over onto race trim. We now have a 25-second penalty on that. It'll give you 8 laps. Your tyres should be okay for that. Go, 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 Mr. Farrar! 4 times. Come on, Leoncio. Move, 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 move. Go, 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 go. Right. Get it up. Overtake and attack. Let's get this outlap under our belt and see exactly what happens. Get up to 2 times. Ultrasoft's level 2. How nice. Alright, we've got quality at level 2. Are we going to get race trim at level 2? We're probably not going to get Ultrasoft's at level 2. 3. Race trim 108. Alright, let's go back to 1 times. Whereabouts is Leoncio? Leoncio's showing in first. Is he going to be able to complete this lap and get onto a new one? You, I'm going to pull back because you're not going to be able to do much. Perfect gear ratios. Gear ratios is not what I'm concerned about. 23 seconds. Get across that line. Move it. I think we've got the race trim level 2 anyway. Now it's just a question of can we get up to level 3 on the Ultrasofts. Leoncio has finished. Didn't quite make it. Oh well. We are not going to get up to level 3 on the Ultrasofts, that much is certain. So we came first and second in practice, which matters not one iota. Leoncio was actually the faster of the two, and that's because we had him out there on red and red, trying to push him around to get out of the outlaps. Jens Bergman is the one who is the slowest, 1:16.346. What is to come is the question. Practice is actually showing his sunshine now. Well, sort of was for part of it. Qualifying is showing his 2 bars. Race is showing his 2 bars. The good news is I don't think anybody else has gotten any practical experience worth a damn either. Let's continue on. Scuderia Quantistica are awesome. Go team. Thank you, Dion. FFS, not happy about how that session went. You and me both, Heggy. You and me both. Farrar was looking solid at the top of the timesheets today. Can he convert it into a good lap tomorrow? No, because he doesn't do the qualifying sessions. Arnold, you've been watching us long enough to know that. Continue. Okay, let's find out what happened in the car setup. Oh, for the love of... All right. Let's forget about trying to center it in the green bar. And if that's good, then obviously we've got to go the other way. So we went 15 point... What's the highest we've gone? 15.0 and 25.0. You know what? I'm going to bet the house. 15.2, 25.2. We shall see how it goes. Okay, so now what's the water like? We've got 2 bars of rain all the way out to just after the 8-minute mark. So the original send-out time on this lot, 7:36 to 7:52... Okay, water on track is not going to be much. All right, so by the time we do the first send out, water on track should be flat. So we will stick with the Ultrasofts on there. Tire choice, okay, confirm that. Let's find out what happened with Daniela's setup. Okay, well, 98% is certainly good enough, but let's try tweaking it. Let's try tweaking it. And I think we'll tweak it on the upside, 15.3, 25.3. It's worth a shot anyway. Again, she won't be going out until the water on track dries out, so that should be fine. Continue and continue. All right, let's get back to the knowledge area. What have we got? We've got Ultra Softs on level 2. We'll obviously take that. Qualifying Trim level 2. We'll obviously take that. Wet Tires, we end up at level 1. We're not going to need those today. Confirm that. Right, Snidely. Oh, good. Snidely does still have the quick fixes. I was concerned he wouldn't because of the way his relationship with Rachel fell. Ultra Soft Tires, qualifying trim. Confirm that. Do these guys not read the memo at all? 756. 752 is actually the first time intended to go out. Water on track is still... Oh, my God. Look at that. Look at that beyond the 5-minute mark. Coming back up with 2 bars of rain right out to the end, as far as we can see. I would say this is the only shot we're going to have at doing a dry time, which means that it's probably going to be our best time, which means that I probably shouldn't have monkeyed with the setups, but it's too late for that now. Send out. 94%, 96%. I don't want to go in with 96%. Let's risk it. All right, Snidely, do something. Oh, it might help if I turn the time back on again. Auto is on. Daniela, continue, send out. Right, out she comes. Auto is on. I might have even been half tempted to try to take that manually, but realistically, we don't get much of a better result. Now, it's interesting that most people are going out on inters. What I'm gambling on is the fact that by the time we hit the flying lap, the water should be dropping. Maybe not for Snide, but certainly for Daniela. Snide's tire temp is cold. Hi, oh, yes. Daniela's is looking more as good. Just good. All right, it's dry at least. We're on the right tyres for dry. All those ones that are out doing it on inters are on the wrong tyres. Snide's got a purple on Sector 1. That's actually not surprising. Although, considering that Hume's on his in-lap, although Hume, if Hume is on his in-lap, or actually is now in the pits, he would have been out there doing this, doing his lap while it was still wet. Now, DeMeo's got a green, not a purple. That's a worry. Snide should actually do pretty well out of this. Two purples. Bloody well better do pretty well out of this. God damn it, that was not great. You're second! What more do you want? Well, I know what more you want. I know what more I want, but I don't think we're going to get it today. Nice, that felt like a good lap. Second and third. Felt good to me, baby. Felt good to me. Next out time. 142, 127. 142 for the first one, 127 for the second one. Let's get up to 2 times. Alright, 332. What are we looking at here? Water on track is going to increase. Actually, let's pause it. Water on track is going to increase, not out of Inters country. Inters will be the right tyre for this, but we don't have a bonus on Inters, but then neither does anybody else in all probability, because as far as I could see, everybody was doing their practice session on dry tyres, except for us, where we did that stint on wets. That's going to keep raining all the way through. Why am I even looking at this? I know what the answer to this question is, but there is some other question that we need an answer to, which is... 98%, great, excellent, excellent. I think at this point we give up. So that, despite this up 4% thing, as you can see, both of them were 98%. And Snide, what about you? Excellent, great, great, 96%. 96%. But we have finally nailed the excellent on the downforce. Now, previously we had an excellent on the speed balance. And the excellent on the speed balance was around about there, further towards the top speed side. Now, if I knock the gear ratios out 1 point, that will overshoot where the excellent was by a pretty fair margin. But if instead I do something I've never done before and tweak the tire camber back to 1.6, minus 1.6, which is a setting I have never used before as best I can recall, that puts it pretty damn close there and bang over the top there. That may well be enough to get it for us. It's a bit risky, but okay. Cancel, because we're not at the time to send Snide out yet. Actually, it probably doesn't matter, because I don't think anybody's going to be able to do a better time than that anyway, because they're all going to be out on wet tires. Well, inters, but those are wet tires of a type. That's it. Get out of here, Snide. Right. That goes to 1.6. Tire choice goes to inters. Good luck. Right, Daniela. You can go now too, because there's a gap in the traffic coming along. Tire choice, that's all we're going to change for you. Get out of here. Go, go, go. There's enough of a gap between them to make a difference. And they're both reasonably clear of traffic, although Daniela has got a couple behind her. That's fine. She's going to be interfering with them, not the other way around. Snide, what can you do? Tire temp looks overheated. In this weather, how is that even possible? All right, Snide. I'm not actually expecting that much. You're still on your outlap. Bring you up to four times to get you around. Perfect. Oh, overheated and perfect. Love it. All right, Hume's got white on sectors 1 and 2. He's still got the best time. That's fine. Quali is ending. All right, we've got white on sector 1 for both drivers. That's not surprising. Obviously, in wet conditions, you're not going to be setting the same times as dry conditions. We timed that first outing pretty much to perfection, I think. White on sector 2. Oh, damn it, that was not... Snide, it doesn't matter. You got second position. Daniela, you got third. That's both of you getting the sponsor objective. That's $500,000 straight into our kick, and one of you gets to sit on the front row, and believe it or not, it's Snide. All right, Thornton. Damn it, Thornton's got pole. Every time Thornton succeeds, it just makes it that much harder for us to do Operation Swing for the Fence. Ruiz Motorsport need to get their act together, specialists in failure. As long as they're behind us, I don't care. Good effort from Scuderia Quantistica today. They'll be hoping for something even better tomorrow. Indeed we will. Sticking my neck out here, but after today's solid qualifying performance, I fancy Scuderia Quantistica for the win tomorrow. Thank you, Carlotta. We're going to try. I don't know that we'll succeed. All right, so what are we looking at here? We are seeing two bars all the way out until those last two visible bars in the chart have nothing underneath them. Water on track is going to be an absolute pain in the backside, so I think it's going to be launch on inters, run inters out to about lap 9, maybe lap 8. Switch over to dry tyres and see what the hell's happening with the weather thereafter. In the meantime, let's take a look at Snide's car setup, I think it was. And we have got... Okay, so we got that excellent back, and that brought it up to 98%. So that's pretty much as we need. So that's it for the qualifying and practice session, or practice and qualifying session for this race. I hope you join me in 12 hours. If you enjoyed this episode, please do click on that like button, subscribe and or comment, or both. Actually, both will be fine by me. Until then, I hope you have a very good weekend, and goodbye.